All right, so let's go back. How many times of the day are you gonna look at your dreams and goals? Good. Oh, I love it. Y'all smart. I thought somebody was gonna three me out, your little average self. You know what I'm saying? I just threw a little three out to see if you was gonna bite that foolishness. Right? You said five. I love it. You're gonna look at it every day. We're gonna create an affirmation. All right? We're gonna create an affirmation. All right? We're gonna create a what?
Affirmation.
Good. We're gonna create an affirmation. All right? And that affirmation, we're going to say what we need to say as it relates to our dreams and goals. Don't let nobody fool you. Words. So there are those of us who feel inadequate because somebody you love told you you wasn't worth anything. You weren't valuable. Somebody divorced you and said some stupid stuff to you when they walked out your life. Somebody broke up with you, said some dumb stuff, and you embraced that foolishness. Now, I need you to get all that stuff out your system, and I just need you to say what you wrote down on your goals. Don't say nothing else that's contrary to that. Does that make sense? So I'll never forget, I was talking to Les Brown. Les Brown, and I ain't know no better, but I said another dude was number one in the world. And Les said, what did you just say? I said, yeah, my man number one, you know what I'm saying? I'm up and coming. Les said, you number one in the world. So the OG could have been like, you number two. The OG was like, yo, you number one. Ain't nobody, he said, let me tell you why nobody else can't be number one right now on the earth. Because ain't nobody else as pure in heart as you are. Nobody is giving out free content, E. Ain't nobody going to prisons. Ain't nobody going to youth detention center. Like, you number one, and you in New Orleans going to a foster care home with 12 kids in it. He like, ain't nobody doing that, E. Listen to what I just said. Some of y'all got it twisted. You think you're number one, or you want to be number one in your industry because of some gift or talent. Do you know you're already number one because of your character? You number one, but you can't see that you number one because you ain't got a Bentley. A Bentley does not make you number one. A house in the gated, I'm number one in the world. I live in a 2,300 square foot home. People come to my crib, they be like, "This, you number, are you, I thought you was number one." I said, I am number one. I don't want to have number one bills. I ain't got to have number one bills. You know, I don't want to have number one responsibility like that. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But I'm number one. I don't have to spend all my money. But I am sending kids to college. I am. Listen to me. I need to be a billionaire. And I wasn't like this before. One of my boys cussed me. I was like, yo, E, why in the world would you let a dude that wants toys be a billionaire when you're doing all this good in the world? Who you think a billion, whose hands you think a billion gonna be better in? My man is buying toys and popping bottles, or you sending kids to study abroad and going to college. Like, bro, you need to be a billionaire. I was like, ah, makes sense, I got it. So in my affirmation, I start putting that, and then I start attracting billionaires. So I need y'all to do me a favor. Before we move forward, five times a day, you putting energy on your stuff, and I was embarrassed that Bill Gates has sent more kids in the hood to college than I have. Bill Gates ain't even been in Detroit. The Bill Gates Millennial Scholarship. Kid get full ride to Michigan State, Michigan, wherever they want to go, plus master's, plus PhD. I'm like, no way possible. I got to be the guy, because I've been in the hood, I got to be the guy that makes that happen. So I need you to write your affirmation. How many times a day?
Five.
Look, now do it in private. Stop telling people your stuff. Come on now, y'all done had babies before. When you have a baby, you don't just let anybody touch your baby, hold your baby. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When your baby first born, you ain't got people coughing over your baby. You ain't got people smoking around your baby. Matter of fact, when you were having your child, if you were smart, you wasn't drinking and smoking because some of you are entrepreneurs, your dream is a baby. It's still young, and you letting people hold it. And they dogging it out, and you want to know why they dogging it out. They ain't supposed to be holding it in the first place. It's your child. Raise your doggone child. Be responsible for your dreams and your goals. They don't belong to nobody else. Nobody's supposed to have the same energy that you have. Nobody's supposed to put those type of resources. All right, let's go. Q&A real quick. I got a couple minutes left. Q&A. I hear you. Talk to me. I see both of y'all. Talk to me. Ladies first. I'm sorry. Talk to me, ma'am. Talk to me quickly. I can hear you. I'll just repeat what you say until they give you a mic.
You,
amen.
You coming, boo. You coming, yeah.
I just want to thank you. I've been wanting to thank you for years, but I think this is the first time I got that 400,000.
You coming, boo. You coming, yeah.
So
I love it. Say it again. Jessica is good enough. On three, if you could just say your name and say you're good enough. One, two, three. Ah, come on. Say it like you mean it. One, two, three. Come on, one, two, three. Okay, Jessica, we're gonna stop. We're gonna fix it. You just said you weren't selling the amount of books I was selling. So when you sell books, do you sell them individually?
Oh, no, sir, I sell them both.
So then we just gonna claim that somebody before this year ends is gonna purchase a 500,000 copies of your book. Come on, let's claim it, let's claim it. Say it out loud, I need to hear you. Yeah. Let's go, let's go, let's go. All right. The way you're going to make your dreams become a reality is that you're gonna add value, okay? Listen to me, and you're not gonna, it's not, you don't add value when you get to pick what you add. Does that make sense? So people come up to me all the time, like a dude came up to me and gave me this sweet bottle of, I don't know what it was, it's at the crib, sitting on thing. It was sweet, my man gave it to me, his wife, it was fire, I mean fire. I'd never seen a bottle of wine like that before. But the only problem is what? I don't drink. You brought me what you want to do. No, I'm not trying to be funny. I need y'all to hear me. This is why some of y'all ain't blowing up in business. You're taking to the marketplace what you want to put in the marketplace. You're not taking to the marketplace. So there's a couple things my man didn't do. One thing, somebody said it. Say it again. He didn't do research. He don't know E.T. Because if he'd have known E.T., E.T. don't drink. So you could have got me like, bruh, you could have saved that bottle. And I kept it out of respect. It might turn into something one day. It's got my name and everything on it. So my kids might be able to sell it one day. I don't know. But I'm like, bruh, what I really would have wanted, bruh, you could have brought me a $100 gift certificate from Chipotle. Like, I could tell, I'm just being real. Like, I could tell you don't rock with me like that. Or Chick-fil-A, you would already know that I'm on that double Oreo cookie cream milkshake. Like, you would have. Like, it would have taken two podcasts for you to know Chipotle is my thing. So here's what, listen to me, you gotta hear me. A lot of you have not blown up, and I saw you, sis. A lot of you have not blown up because you wanna add the type of value that you wanna add. I've blown up because I've added the type of value that you need. Whether I wanted to do it or not, in the recession, I came out with my videos. Why? Because I knew I had a gift, and I know that your gift shall make room for you. So I brought my stuff out during a recession because I knew you needed to be motivated or your mama needed to be motivated. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? And so what I would do is when I would, somebody like, yo, hey, bro, I swear, it's like you came straight through the computer into my living room and you spoke directly to me. Hey, how do you do it? By reading your comments. I'll just be reading the comments like, yo, E, bro, I feel like I can't take it no more. E, I just feel like the pain is too much. What up, what up, what up? It's your boy, E.T. Look, do you feel like the pain is just too much? You just can't take it anymore. You feel stressed out. I'm talking to you. Everybody like, yo, E, unbelievable, E. Some of you are so selfish and so self-centered that you're giving me what you want. You are so selfish and so self-centered. You trying to blow up and it's obvious you bought the money. You so dumb as an entrepreneur. You don't even do that when you date. When you date, you know what you want and you able to pretend like that's not what you want. You do a better job in dating with homegirl. Like, you making her feel like this all about her. Like, you set it up. But in the back of your mind, you would already know on date one. You were just like, oh, this one's gonna take about five dates right here. Six dates, yeah. But when you do business, because you're so selfish and self-centered, you come right out like, I want your money, that's why I'm here. I gave my stuff away for 10 years. I became number one in the world and still giving it out. People say, E, why are you still giving it out? And you blew up because you still gonna come and hear the album. If I give you the album, you're still gonna come to the concert. It ain't like you listen to Drake and don't pay to go to the concert. So I know if I give it out, guess what? My sheep will know my voice and they will come. So I put my stuff out, and when people say you're too loud, up, that means I'm not for you. Your vocabulary is too rudimentary, up, that means I'm not for you. I don't go, he just made a negative comment. I just go, yep, I'm not for you. There's 7 billion people in the world. Cut that up. You tripping off with 5, 6, 7 people saying like it ain't 7 billion people on the planet Earth. You let one person discourage you. Give out value and you'll find yourself in venues like this.
What's up? It's your boy E.T. Hey, the Riviera, baby. This year, we doing it big. Y'all gotta be there. Mexico, let's go. All right, so you saying, what we gonna get, E? Yo, the triple double. Like, for real, y'all know all about the triple double life. What does that mean? It means you're not dominant or successful just in one area. And some of y'all are fruitful, but you're not multiplying. Some of y'all are fruitful, multiplying, but you don't have dominion. So what I want you to do is have dominion in every area. Yo, it sucks to have a great marriage, but you're broke. Or to have a lot of money, right? But your relationships are messed up. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna show you how to dominate, not fruitful, multiply, but dominate in your mindset, in your marriage or relationships, in your finances, in your health. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Like, every single area, y'all. All right, a lot of y'all getting it, but you can't keep it. So we're not gonna lose nothing. No money left behind, no relationship left behind. Our health, you're gonna learn to dominate in your health, in your fitness. All right, every area, let's go.